is Welcome to Previewed, where friends don't let friends watch trailers alone.
I'm Adam.
And I'm Jay.
And we're back from vacation.
We're back. Baby. Oh, yeah.
Oh, this is going to be a long video. A lot of things popped up over the past week when we were gone, and actually before that, because we were worried about doing the crowd work. So today, we're going to react, review, riff, and at the end, rate a whole bunch of trailers, because once again, we just happen to be gaming the system, baby!
Yeah! And we're gaming the system times two today, because we're also including in this trailer palooza a special unboxing of a very special plaque.
Oh, blah, 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 blah.
Oh, and some would say, please do it right now. Nay, nay. No, no.
Oh, we're not? We're going to hold on to that to the end, huh?
Yeah, we're doing that at the very end. Do you think we're going to do it right at the top?
I did.
Really?
I thought.
We gotta keep them hooked.
You're right, we do. We do have to game the system.
We gotta game the system, baby.
Wow, sorry, everybody, and me. We're doing that in the next, in 45 minutes
or
so.
You have to sit through all of our ramblings and burps and farts and nonsense.
Yeah, all the throat clearing and the coughing in this season.
Yeah, and then it's just the half witty quips about certain trailers we're gonna watch.
Yes, you guys sent these in on Discord. Since things were so busy with Vox Machina and getting ready for crowd work last weekend, we did not have time to do this.
Nope.
But now we do, because in the next couple weeks, there are no shows out, so
no.
There's gonna be lots of fun, cool community stuff going
on all
of the streaming stuff on the Discords. If trailers pop up, obviously we'll do them here.
Yeah.
Especially like some Star Wars stuff pops up or some Marvel stuff, we'll get one-offs, but otherwise, we'll wait for another palooza. So let's start this one, so we can hurry up and get to that thing.
I really thought we were going to leave with that. How long have we been in show business?
Jesus.
You got to wait to the end for 15 this.
15 years.
You gotta bury the lead a little
bit.
Yeah,
you do.
You got to keep that retention high.
Yeah.
Or skip to this time code.
I chaptered the end. Like, there's chapters below, so you can see when we do it. But
it's
watch the
fun.
Whole thing. It's more fun.
Yeah. It's also building suspense for you, too.
I guess. I know. Because I don't know if you guys watch crowd work, but my dad sneakily sent us a plaque that's now hanging above the TV here in the studio. You can't see it. Maybe I'll put a picture of what it looks like up. It's right there. It's very nice. So it's like above. It's just watching us saying, good job, guys.
And it's going to have a buddy very soon.
It's going to have a buddy very soon.
It's going to have a buddy very
maybe
soon.
Maybe like at about, reading the time code, about 35 minutes from now.
35 minutes.
There are 5 trailers.
Okay.
You know how we talk. You know how we ramble on.
We're going to make you jitter every single second.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so our first trailer is the first trailer that kind of came out in the last couple weeks that everyone really wanted us to do. Unfortunately, we just didn't have time. This is the teaser trailer for the Chippendale Rescue Rangers movie? Movie.
I
think this is a movie.
All right.
I don't know, but it's such
a... Did you watch this show as a kid?
You know what?
I really did.
I did not.
Oh, yeah, because you're a little
bit
older.
Because that was that second-gen Disney afternoon.
Oh, yeah, man.
That I just... I didn't... Yeah.
And that's my sweet spot. We're talking DuckTales. We're talking Darkwing Duck. We're talking Tailspin, Chippendale Rescue Rangers.
Tailspin and Rescue Rangers.
Oh, it was a chock-a-block 2 hours of television.
I missed the Gummy Bears.
Oh, yeah. Well, Gummy Bears was a little bit before, as I was coming into it, Gummy Bears was kind of phasing out a little bit.
Mm-hmm,
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They were jumping here, there, and everywhere and kind of out of the zeitgeist.
Out of the schedule, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. All right, let's do this thing.
Here we go. Chippendale's Rescue Rangers.
Real Hollywood Story. Chippendale Rescue Rangers, the show that defined a generation and turned two unknown chipmunks into international superstars. Sometimes. But his success took Chippendale to new heights.
To many more seasons of the Rescue Rangers.
We were living the dream, dancing the Roger Rabbit with Roger Rabbit.
No one ever imagined.
Sighty.
It could all come crashing down. Torn by vanity.
You look different.
Hey, it's no secret I had the CGI surgery done.
Consumed by temptation.
My love of cheese got the best of me.
I just love it so much.
More, please. More, please.
Is it possible that two living legends are destined to reunite?
I'm thinking reboot.
Nobody wants a reboot.
It's the Rescue Rangers.
You need a disguise or something. Grab the first thing you can.
What?
Rescue Rangers 2.0.
This place looks weird.
Remember that animation style where everything looked real, but nothing looked right?
Who are you?
Are you talking to us?
Obviously.
But it looks like you're talking to that window.
It actually looks like I'm looking right at you.
Okay.
Look at my eyes, looking right at your eyes.
Yeah.
That looks awesome. That looks, and it's interesting that they had Roger Rabbit in the beginning of
yes.
that. Because I'm getting
yes.
serious Roger Rabbit.
Yes.
Like, it almost indicates to me that, like, it's taking place in the same universe
yes.
as Who Framed Roger Rabbit in a way that I'm going to be honest with you. We got a lot of people in the Discord telling us that we need to do this trailer, and the whole time I was like...
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
I mean, sure, guys. Okay. I mean, I, you know, like, they like the show, too, but, like...
Okay. I love Chip and Dale Rescue Rangers, but, like, you know, I don't know if it's necessarily required reading at this point, but that looks awesome.
The fact that Disney seemed like they would actually let them to be like, oh, Lonely Island, you guys want to do a deconstruction of the Disney afternoon from 30 years ago mm-hmm. that all of you guys grew up on? Yeah, sure,
it'd
go
take
for
place
it.
In the Who Framed Roger Rabbit universe? There's just like a Toontown? Yeah. Uh-huh. Because what would Toontown look like in a CG world?
Slash, nowadays, just how it would handle nowadays.
Yeah.
With all the things that have happened in Hollywood and animation since then. And also, the thing they didn't show us in this teaser trailer... The one character I am most looking forward to seeing.
Gadget?
Yup. Some people wonder about some of the things that millennials like. And you're like, okay, really? You wonder where it came from? I direct you towards the Disney afternoon. All
yeah.
right?
Yeah,
just
man.
Watch these 7 years worth of cartoons until we don't come out of those things and be like, you know what?
Maybe I'm a furry.
Yeah, you know what?
Maybe.
Demona? Kind of hot. Yeah. For a gargoyle? Hey, you got a Counselor Troy's voice? I mean, pretty hot. Pretty.
You know
hot.
We're Chip and Dale, right?
Of course.
Yeah. That's like totally our vibe.
Which one is which, though?
Are you.
Again, remember, I didn't watch the show.
Oh, dude, you're Chip and I'm Dale.
Okay.
The one with the red nose and the Hawaiian shirt?
Yeah, that's you.
Yes.
Dale.
Okay. Okay. Yeah.
I'm Chip. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I thought...
I couldn't...
Okay.
Gun to my head, I wouldn't have been able to figure out which one was which. It'd be 50-50.
Oh, really? Something.
Oh, yeah. I don't know.
Well, you know, now that the naming convention isn't necessarily as obvious as you would think it would be.
Yeah, like, do you know which color the kids were in DuckTales? Huey, Dewey, and Louie, what the colors were? Could you pick them out in a lineup?
No.
Yeah. Because it was the same character, just with a different color.
Yeah, pretty much. Well, to be fair, Chip and Dale Rescue Rangers was a large expansion on the idea of Chip and Dale.
Oh, absolutely.
Because Chip and Dale were just chipmunks.
Just, yeah.
One was fun, one had the red nose and one didn't.
But just a normal comedy duo.
Yeah, I love Chip and Dale. They're like one of my favorites. I love them. That we have one of the pictures that we actually framed from our honeymoon in Disney is a picture of me and Kimberly with Chip and Dale. It's just a good picture of us. We're both all very happy, but everyone's just so happy. I was like, oh, this is a happy picture of us.
That's nice.
Chip and Dale. They're just so funny. They're just chipmunks. What a stupid thing.
Yeah.
It's the best. Man,
I'm looking. This movie comes out in May? The end of the May?
It's coming right to Disney Plus.
Yeah, it's right to Disney Plus, yeah. Boop, 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 boop. Yeah, I think it's straight to streaming. Yep, May 20th.
It's interesting.
Wow, that. And a nice. Like, just.
Oh, and Akiva directed this? This is like actually Lonely Island.
Yeah, this is Lonely Island. Yeah, mm-hmm. And Sandberg was the voice of
Dale. Oh yeah, 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 yeah.
Lanny and yeah. That wow.
But this is like yeah, this is like hot rod level comedy. I am on board.
Yeah.
Have you seen Hot Rod?
No.
God, that movie's hilarious.
Did you see Never Stop?
Oh yeah,
yeah.
Did we see that together?
We did not.
I saw it with somebody.
I watched it on my own.
Maybe seen it with Brian.
I really enjoyed that movie too.
Yeah, it was a hoot.
That was a lot. Yeah.
Yeah, it was fun. Really fun. It's like sometimes, like those are the kind of movies. It's like, ah, no, you know, you don't have to be a huge cultural touchstone to make a funny movie.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it felt like a new generation of like an Airplane kind of vibe.
Yeah,
you know,
mm-hmm.
Like
just,
it's like
non sequiturs. All mm-hmm. It's all very silly.
Yeah.
All right. Jay, how would you rate the trailer for Chippendales Rescue? Just Chippendales? Just
this one's getting 0 out of 0. Missing Gadgets. Where are you? We want to see you.
I want to see what happened to Gadget afterwards.
What? You know what? I brought it back up, and maybe that's my fault.
No, they showed what's going on with Chip and Dale and their elder Jack. Friend.
Monterey Jack is.
Oh, Monterey name. Jack.
With a cheese addiction.
Yeah. I went to a cheese den. Clearly, that one mouse was tripping on cheese.
More, please.
Yeah. So, like, but they didn't show us. Probably because they knew there were a lot of little boys that grew up with a general appreciation of Gadget.
Yeah.
And they want to know what happened to Gadget.
Yeah. And she's smart, and she makes gadgets.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, she's like, you know what she's the precursor? She's the precursor to Kylie from Firefly.
Okay, yeah. She's the next iteration of Penny from Inspector Gadget.
Yes. Yes. Similar vibe.
Mm-hmm.
Similar vibe. All right.
All right. Moving on to a different, definitely change in tone. This is a movie with starring Chris Pine.
Chris Pine?
It's called The Contractor. I don't know anything about it.
The Contractor.
The Contractor.
Okay.
He is the one you call to contract something.
Is this like, okay, is he like secretly a spy?
Probably. I don't know anything. Of all the trailers, this
bet is you $10.
The one I know the least about.
He's the guy that tried to get out of the spy game, and they keep pulling him back in.
Probably. Okay, then what happened?
Then he starts his own joke shop company.
Oh.
And it's all about the ins and outs of, you know, being a serious businessman in a silly world. And his son gets powers.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, a lot happens
in this movie.
It
turns into a Raising Dion situation.
Yep, and they shot this in real time, so it's like the boy with what's his name. So they've shot, this is 30 years in the making.
Yep, of Chris Pine.
And it's a different genre every film. It's really quite a triumph.
And let us watch the trailer for that triumph right now. Here we go.
What's a better soldier, you or my dad?
Careful.
Come on, let's go.
Did you actually see my dad's wife?
Yes. We looked after each other.
Kind of like brothers.
Yeah, kind of like brothers.
Murder brothers.
James, they're cleaning house.
You're leaving the army with an honorable discharge, but you're losing your pension and health care.
Excuse me?
We gave them our minds, our bodies, and our spirit. And they chewed us up and spit us out.
I just want to check in with y'all on your past due payment.
Message deleted.
What you did in uniform?
Hey!
Sledgehammer shit. Our thing, scalpel work. We operate in a deep black OGA offshoot with direct presidential authority.
Bank some decent cash, put a down payment on the house.
That's not dangerous.
Hey, right.
Now I know you're lying.
Maybe I need to take care of my family.
So what do you say? You're down for the cause?
Yeah.
Okay. Salim Mohammed Mosin. Study pathogenic influenza viruses in humans.
We all know what one motivated radical can do. So let's cowboy up, get it done, and get home to our families.
You don't understand what you're doing. I'm trying to save lives. This is only about money.
What do we do, Mike?
I've got an extraction team around BMW X1. Comply.
I'll do that when you confirm who you're working for.
You work for me.
You gotta trust me. I am trying to help you.
Oh, we're working for the president.
What corporation?
Get in the car!
Woo!
All right. Train us to run their errands. Kill their enemies and kill each other. It's
easy to kill, but it's much harder to survive.
I need to get back home.
Home's a memory.
He's gonna come after you with everything he's got.
I'm going home.
Okay.
Mm, you know what?
Okay.
All right.
That's got all the right pieces in place.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
I mean, Kiefer Sutherland, already I'm in.
Yeah.
Man, I don't know what... I think it's like just 24 as a show had such a very huge impact on me. And that anytime Kiefer Sutherland is in anything, I'm like, oh, okay, great, I'm on board.
Oh, really?
They got Jack Bauer? Yeah. Yeah, man. Oh, yeah. It was very profound. That like, the first, like, two seasons of 20... Have you seen them?
When Netflix first started its streaming service...
That's how I watched it.
That was the first time I watched the first five seasons.
Me and my dad, I was... it was when my dad was... my dad had moved to a new job, but we had not necessarily... the rest of the family hadn't moved, but he was closer to my college. Mm-hmm. So I spent spring break at my dad at his place, mm-hmm. Before, like, because he was trying to find a house for everybody.
Right.
And it was just like, he was just in his, like, we called it his, like, bachelor pad.
I was about to say, yeah.
Because he was just like, hey, I'm glad you're here. Oh, we spent an entire week and we just hammered 24. He was like, I got this Netflix thing. They send you DVDs. And man, we just, like literally my dad would call me when he was getting off of work and be like, cool, I'm going to be there in a half hour. He was like, order the pizza, get the DVD rolling. We getting in. Like, it was, man, 24. That's such a good memory of me and my dad. That was so fun.
That's nice.
That was great.
You, your dad, Jack Bauer, killing
Jack terrorists. Bauer, just taking care of business, all in 24 hours. Sorry, I had to completely, like, try to remember what you were going to say, because I just...
Yes, I agree with what you said.
So we agree that Ben Foster, like, does not make it out of that first mission, right? Because he was nowhere to be seen in that second half of that trailer.
No.
Which bums me out, because they killed Ben Foster in everything. He always is so good in everything.
Oh, he's the killable best friend.
Yeah, he's Sean Bean. He's like the next generation Sean Bean. Mm-hmm. He's never making it out of the film.
He's Mr. Inciting Incident.
Yeah. God, he's so... I think he's such an incredible actor. He's so good.
That's why they bring him in. He is the contractor.
Yeah, that makes a splash.
That makes a splash in the first 20 minutes to get the audience to really like him, and then they murder him horribly to make sure the main character has...
Uh-huh.
A drive to do the rest of the movie.
Yeah.
That's how good he is.
Yeah.
He only needs a couple minutes. God. It hooks you.
He says, you ever see the remake of 310 to Yuma?
No.
He's so scary in that. He's one of the bad guys.
Oh.
He's like the second banana to Russell Crowe.
Oh. He's the first banana?
Oh, he's so scary.
Oh, okay.
I love Ben Foster. He's so talented.
Okay, great. Well, this movie comes out on the Paramount Plus.
And this looks good.
It does look good. This does look good. This comes out a week after Halo drops. So,
oh yeah,
another, I guess, maybe
Paramount's
possible reason.
Some plays.
Another possible reason to check out Paramount Plus. Although
yes,
I'll say their commercials are horrible. Have you seen Paramount Plus's commercials?
They're not evocative.
They don't know what they're doing with the commercials.
They don't give me a call.
They really
to
don't.
Action,
oh, then, they don't. It's like, meanwhile on Paramount Mountain, no.
Nah.
That's not a thing.
Nah.
Don't stop trying to make Paramount Mountain a thing.
Yeah.
All the characters under your loose umbrella that have no actual corporate synergy with each other, do not all hang out with each other.
No.
Stop. This is not like Disney, which it does kind of make sense.
But they've earned that.
And they have earned that.
They've earned it. They built a whole theme park around it. They've earned it.
Yes. Paramount.
You can't just
like squeeze Spock in with some of the characters from The Good Wife. It doesn't make sense.
But also, you didn't pick your properties right.
You really didn't.
Like, I would mean Spock hanging out with Master Chief? Okay.
That's one thing,
I can get
sure.
Down I
but,
can,
like, yeah.
Maybe I can
he
swallow
doesn't,
that.
No. It's just not...
Yeah.
Sorry, Paramount. Moving on. Oh, Jay, how would you rate the trailer? I'm going to remember how we do these palooses. Jay, how would you rate the trailer for The Contractor?
Man, this one's getting 23 out of 24 hours. You only got 1 hour left. You got to get it done, Chris Pine. The clock's a ticking. Boop.
dude, seriously, you think those last hours?
Oh yeah, man.
Oh what, man?
Yeah.
First 5 seasons of that show were fantastic.
Yeah, man. Chloe at the computer.
Oh. Guy at the computer for a while. And then other guy at the computer.
Yeah, it just wasn't as... Dude, it wasn't... When it wasn't Chloe anymore, it just wasn't as good.
Yeah, the later seasons definitely got... Yeah,
you just need Marilyn. Like, you need her. Like, she was... She was the perfect, like...
She was the hacker queen.
But she was, like, the perfect, like, sweet to the salty, but salty to the sweet. It was perfect.
What you're saying is that 24 had a certain umami?
Yeah. What's that flavor, Adam?
Would it be like a...
Forget it. let's keep going.
Moving on. Coming up now is the trailer for the second season of a show both Jay and I really like.
And we didn't watch long enough. Nobody watched. We were cutting our teeth.
Apparently enough people watched that it got a second season. But we will not be doing this on the channel.
No.
But please watch the show. I'm going to watch this show when it comes out.
It's a hoot.
It is a fun, good show with a good cast. It is the trailer for season 2 of Upload.
3, 2, 1, Upload.
I notice you're really lonely and sad, and you often express your feelings as anger.
You, Helen.
I know that. Welcome to Upload, your digital afterlife.
Uploads live a life of luxury, pleasure, but they lack something that makes death worth living. Prototypes!
Congrats, Mommy.
Welcome back, Nora.
Really?
Thanks. It's been a long time.
Next.
I got so much to tell you.
We've had one extremely difficult camera.
Let me speak to a manager.
What seems to be the problem?
You're a moron.
You've been cheating on me.
Ingrid gave up everything and uploaded for me.
I'm with someone too.
I've been cheating on you.
Oh. It's all good, brother. That was weird.
So weird. I know.
Uploading should be accessible for everyone. We need to hold the greedy, powerful people accountable.
He likes Bloody Marys and the rollback of environmental laws.
Well, we can handle one of those.
This life, we're taking this place over.
Oh, it's on!
Thank you.
Place your bets.
You can listen in on any upload.
Mm, do me.
Oh my God, look at her. She's so beautiful.
This
life. Oh. Anything else about me?
You were considering bicep inflation.
A little bigger. Just a little more. Perfect. It's so ridiculous.
That, huh. Mm-hmm. Huh. Because I don't think that's selling the show very well.
No, it's not.
Because that's not what the show is about.
Not really, no.
Like, not even close.
No. I feel like they feel like they're trying to like sell the show over again.
Yeah,
you know what I mean. Like I'm always like, so what's going on with the characters that we like? Like,
because Robbie Amell is a good
man
actor.
How hesitant were they when they greenlit a second season on this? Because that trailer to me indicates that they're like, I mean, you know,
because this show's a murder mystery.
Yeah.
Like, at no point in any of that trailer did it touch on the actual main story of this show.
Not at all.
Like, it's a huge thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, yes, that was what we were most surprised about in the first season. Like, I thought there was going to be a funny comedy about this possible uploading yourself, which is kind of, you know, the thing. Like, ooh, that sounds like a good idea. I don't want to die. Upload my consciousness to the cloud.
Yeah.
Huzzah. But like, oh, but it's a lot more than just that. He gets murdered. He gets put into the thing.
Yeah.
There's a rich versus poor because, like, somebody wants to buy or keep people. No, Robbie wanted to have the upload stuff available to everybody. Doesn't matter. That's what happens. You guys can just do it. And, like, and rich people are like, no, man, this is just for us to keep being rich and doing things and living, and the poor people can just die and whatever. I was like, oh, wait, it's a class struggle? Murder mystery?
Yeah.
Where's Cousin Fran?
Where's
Cousin Fran, yo? There's no way... There's no way she died in that car.
Smartest person in the room.
one of the best characters from season one.
I don't know.
Nobody.
They
didn't show anybody. There is a resistance out there to what's going on. I'm just saying, the show was a lot of things, a lot of really good ideas that were done pretty funny. And if it was apparently one of like the number one comedies on Amazon Prime a couple years ago.
We had a great time watching it. Check out our watch-alongs if you want to see them. I mean, they're fun.
They're fun. But man.
I think, you know, and we bring it up in the watch-alongs a lot, and it's something that the show always brings me back. The fact that I can't upload into like a video game of some kind. The fact that I can't be, you know... I think about it like this. Like, if you got uploaded into, like, a LARPing universe...
Yes.
With, like, all, like... Like, I'm talking, hugely MMORPG.
Yes.
But, like, it would be the kind of thing where it's like, oh, you'd be given, like, 5 years in real time to go from level 1 to level 20.
Sure.
And, like, there would just be, like... And then every 5 years, there would just be a reset and be like, you know what? I'm gonna be a monk this time. And they're like, oh, here's the new world and game mechanics you're loading into.
Yes.
Like, yes.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Like, they're like, oh, it's like, oh, you're like living on a resort the whole time. I'm like, I don't think that wouldn't get really, really boring really, really fast.
I mean, yes.
I want loot. I want loot.
Jay, what do you want to do for eternity?
Like, oh,
I want that loot grind,
yeah,
baby.
Yeah, get on that loot treadmill. Let's party. Ooh, what's your item level? Ooh, it's high. Yeah, buddy. Ooh, woo.
I mean,
do you know the drop percentage on this mount? It's low.
And I've been at this for 100 years. No, the show's great. It's, you know, the story it's trying to tell is a good story, and they're telling it in a good way.
Oh, yeah.
But it's just them telling the story pretty much precludes them from doing the things that, like, gamers and stuff would be like, hey, this should be more like Ready Player One!
Yeah.
But they clearly can't do that.
I get it.
Yeah. But it's a good story. Highly recommend the show if you haven't watched it. Our watch-alongs of season one are out there. I highly recommend watching those as well. Jay, how would you rate the trailer for season two of Upload?
Upload is getting 1 out of 2. Hey, maybe the next trailer you should actually tell us what's going on in the plot.
Yeah, because it was like a big deal that Robbie's girlfriend uploaded herself.
Yes.
Like, it was a huge deal because,
like,
she
fine. She's being a big Karen. I'm like,
she decided to upload us like way early.
Like, there is a mystery afoot.
Yeah, people are dying over this thing.
Yeah.
It's a big deal.
Uh-huh.
There's a lot going on.
Yes.
So, yeah, that's weird. I wonder why they made that decision. Anyways, moving on. Our next trailer is for a trailer that just came out today. It's for a movie that's coming out very soon. Is a threequel to a series that probably shouldn't exist, but you know what, whatever. It seems like some people are having a good time. It is the official second trailer for Fantastic Beasts, The Secrets of Dumbledore!
Do we know when this is coming out?
Yeah, like in May? April? Oh, crap. April 15th.
Oh, okay. So soon.
So soon.
All right.
Sooner than I thought. Here we go.
Memory is everything. Without it, we are blind. Without it, we leave the fate of our world to chance.
I'm sorry to disturb you, Albus, but I've just received troubling news.
Tell me, what is it?
It's Grindelwald.
Our time is close, my brothers and sisters.
Our war with the Muggles begins today!
The world as we know it is coming undone. If we're to defeat him, you'll have to trust me.
Mr. Kowalski, we need you.
I said I want an out and I want out.
Ah! You do know I'm a witch, right?
He's a
Dumbledore asked that I give you something, Jacob.
This is the team that's gonna take down the most dangerous wizard in a century. Who wouldn't like our chances?
No one can know everything, not even you.
What you're doing is madness.
With or without you, I'll burn down their world.
Dangerous times favor dangerous men.
If by tea time all of us are still alive, you should consider our efforts a success. Mr. Kowalski.
My pleasure.
Do you really intend to turn your back on your own kind? It was you who said we could reshape the world.
Even if we make mistakes.
F you!
We can try to make things right. We're gonna need some help.
There's nothing you can do to stop me.
Things are not quite what they appear.
I trust you're enjoying your wand, Mr. Kowalski.
Can I keep this?
It breaks down the same way that the last one did. In that, why are these Fantastic Beasts movies? Do you know what I mean?
Yes.
Like, here's the thing. All this stuff with Grindelwald and Dumbledore, I'm like actually kind of into it.
Oh, absolutely. It's just, that's the story.
And the thing is that I actually kind of liked the first Fantastic Beasts movie. I just think it could have been its own thing. And then it could have like been like a sort of like Horse and His Boy style prequel into like a Dumbledore and Grindelwald trilogy. And like you could have had maybe Newt in and out, but like making him the main character, it just muddies the water so much that I'm like, who are we supposed to be paying attention to this movie? Because you cast Jude Law as Dumbledore, he kind of overshadows everything. Sorry, he's sexy Dumbledore, and the movie, I like Eddie Redmayne. I like all the characters from Fantastic Beasts, but why?
All of the characters from Fantastic Beasts?
Well, you like Eddie Redmayne and you like Dan Fogler. I couldn't...
Yes.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Those two.
But I couldn't tell you who the other people were. Save my life.
Nope. Orator, who was angry about stuff, and her sister, who was in the second one and somehow got convinced to be evil because...
Yeah, because reasons...
The dumbest of reasons, because the plot demanded it, and that is not a good reason for a character to do things. Yeah, man, I just want to see the story about Dumbledore and Grindelwald, and it feels like this one's closer to what them trying to do that.
I do like seeing the creatures. You know, it is fun, but at a certain point, I'm like, they just crammed two movies into one movie. In a way that I'm like, both of these could be fit. It could be cool.
I
just feel like you had an opportunity in the Fantastic Beasts world to like have like kind of like an Indiana Jones style adventure in the world of Harry Potter. But they were like, well, people won't take it seriously unless it has some of the Harry Potter characters. And I was like, I would posit that is incorrect. If anything, if we learned anything, like, if anything, the Fantastic Beasts could have transitioned into its own show somewhere else. Do you know what I mean? I would show up for, like, an episodic thing of that.
Oh, sure, on HBO more. Max? Yeah. HBO Max, I mean, you're doing a very good job, but how come we don't have, like, a Harry Potter show of, like, I don't know, Aurors in America in current times? You know, something cool like that.
Something cool like that.
I don't know.
I don't know, man.
I mean, I don't know.
We didn't really like the last one.
The second one was really... Oh, I mean, hopefully this one... They talked too much. The movie was all talking.
Yeah, it was
all talking, no action.
Maybe this one's going to be more like... Oh, well, lizard fights.
They spent all last movie expositioning, so maybe this one you'd be like, hey, okay, you've learned everything. Here we go. You've learned the genealogy of all the characters, so now they can, like, be in conflict and do things.
For real.
I don't know. I guess we'll see. Jay, how would you rate the second trailer for Fantastic Beasts 3?
This is getting 1 out of 1 sexy Dumbledores. I said it once, I'll say it again. He's the only thing that really we're showing up for.
Yeah. Jude Law was already magic, and then you cast him as someone with magic? Hell yeah, man.
Yeah, man.
Can't go wrong with that.
I don't know what to tell you.
All right. Final trailer. Here we go. This one, you guys, oh boy, did you guys really want us to watch this trailer?
Yeah.
Like, seriously. We got a lot of comments.
A lot of comments.
On videos and on the Discord. I don't know anything about who this gentleman is, who is the director of this
Baz
movie.
Baz Luhrmann?
Yeah, who is that?
What are you talking about? You don't know who Baz Luhrmann is?
No.
Moulin Rouge? Romeo and Juliet? Across the Universe? Baz Luhrmann. No, Across the Universe was not Baz Luhrmann. Sorry. But Moulin Rouge, dude. You know who Baz Luhrmann is. You never seen Moulin Rouge?
No.
What? Really? Did you ever see his Romeo and Juliet with Leo and...
No.
Really? Really? You don't know Baz Luhrmann?
I don't.
Okay, he's...
Yeah, people were making a big deal out of this. I just... Singing and dancing and loving stuff? Those are not the types of movies I watch.
Yeah, because Across the Universe was Julie Taymor, right? Or was it about... I can't remember. But, okay. It's about Elvis, right? Like, Elvis?
Elvis. Yeah, all right. The king.
I think this could be cool, then.
Uh-huh.
I didn't realize it was Baz Luhrmann. That's awesome.
Well, I mean, the title of the movie is Baz Luhrmann's Elvis.
Yeah, that's how he does it.
Is that how he does it?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Has he earned the right to do that?
I would say so.
Okay, great. Okay, here is the trailer.
He's the kind of director, you don't always agree with his choices, but he's making choices.
He makes strong choices.
You know what I mean?
I can understand that. Yeah. Okay, here we go.
There are some who'd make me out to be the villain of this here story. Just don't let a good thing die. Are you born with destiny? Or does it just come knocking at your door?
He's a young singer from Memphis, Tennessee. Give him a warm hayride welcome. Mr. Elvis Presley!
Get a haircut, buttercup!
In that moment, I watched that skinny boy transform into a superhero.
Whoa!
Yeah, you didn't know that was his voiceover.
I couldn't tell.
Was my destiny.
I wish to promote you, Mr. Presley.
Born to a party in a town of jail.
Are you ready to fly?
I'm ready. Ready to fly.
Tomorrow, all of America will be talking about Elvis Presley.
I can't move. I can't sing. Some people want to put me in jail. The whale's moving.
They might put me in jail for walking across the street, but you're a famous white boy.
The way he sings is God-given, so there can't be nothing wrong with it.
Senator Kennedy has been shot.
Martin Luther King has been shot to death in Memphis.
That's all right for you.
Tragedy, but it has nothing to do with us.
It has everything to do with us.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
My darling.
Reverend once told me, when things are too dangerous to say, sing.
Sing!
I'm gonna be 40 soon, and nobody's gonna remember me. I need to get back to who I really am. And who are you, Oz? Making the most of this thing while I can. This could all be over in a flash.
We are the same, you and I. We are two odd, lonely children reaching for eternity.
Yeah.
the greatest show on earth.
Elvis has left the building.
Hot damn.
I think that kid's going to win an Oscar.
This is going to be the movie that... This is going to be the movie that everyone's talking about one way or another. I think this is going to be like the most like love-hate movie. I mean, and that's Baz Luhrmann. I mean, there are people that are just like, I just like don't. But like, this seems like all the pieces are there. Because I was like, Baz Luhrmann doing an Elvis thing. But then as it goes on, I'm like, oh yeah, he really was. He is like... It's an American folktale, almost, is like the rise of Elvis. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, I don't think anyone has ever, will ever rise to, it's like, it is like Elvis and Michael Jackson. Like, those are the two that ever got to, like...
The King of Pop.
Just, the King of Rock, King of Pop, like, that's, it just doesn't happen anymore.
I mean, I was thinking, like, the closest... Two that we've had so far is probably Justin Timberlake.
I would say Gaga is getting.
Oh, that's a good yeah. Well, would you? I kind of almost want to put them like in a different category.
I mean
Madonna, Gaga.
Madonna, yeah. I mean, but
Queen
just
B, like some different.
Yeah. But like that's like what a that looks incredible. Like I was saying. Big swings.
Oh, just, yeah. Those
big
are,
swings.
Yeah.
Like, but I think this is, like, maybe, like, the perfect...
Story?
Yeah.
For his style?
Mm-hmm.
Because he's definitely got style coming
You've
out every
really
four.
Never seen Moulin Rouge.
What? No.
Man has never made you watch it?
No.
Man, it doesn't make you do much of anything, huh?
Nope.
Cool.
Mm-hmm. She's wonderful. She is. I never watched Moulin Rouge, yeah. I don't like musicals,
I'm going
to
make Amanda watch, make you watch Moulin Rouge.
You're going to make Amanda make me watch the thing?
Yeah.
Wow.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yeah. It's a classic!
I guess, sure.
All right. See, and that's why she's not going to make you watch it, because you're no fun to watch when you don't want to do something.
Yes.
This looks awesome. I when is this coming out?
It comes out in June, the end of June.
Oh, okay. Man, we got a long ways to wait on that.
Yeah, that does look good. I probably won't watch it, but it does look really good.
Yeah, makes
and
sense.
I think that kid's gonna do great. That his voice
God,
was.
He sounds just like him.
Yeah, he looks sounds just
spooky.
Like him.
Spooky.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Jay, how would you rate the trailer for Baz Luhrmann's Elvis?
Ooh, this one's getting 1 million out of 1 million just sparkles.
Rhinestones?
Ooh, rhinestones. Yeah, rhinestones. 1 million out of 1 million rhinestones. That's, oof. They got the outfits right. They just nailed it. They just nailed it.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, look great. Okay, the moment everyone has been waiting for, including me.
You really thought we were going to do
I
this?
I really
like,
did.
Right
I thought we
were
going to lead it off the thing. I don't know why I thought that.
You gotta build the suspense.
Yeah, build the tension, yeah.
Show business.
I got it.
For those of you at home who don't know what we're talking about, we as a channel just hit 100,000 subs. We had a celebratory live episode to celebrate 100,000 subs, mm-hmm. and thank you for all who come into that. It was really...
There was a lot of you. We really
If you haven't
it.
Seen it yet, go back and watch. It really was a special show. We had a lot of fun. You guys are...
There are a lot of surprises in it, too.
The peaches are the best, mm-hmm. if we've learned anything. And so, what came in the mail this week, and we've been waiting for it, 100,000 subscriber plaque has arrived. I'm going to give you the honor.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, we thought it might, by chance, show when we're the day before we were doing the stream, but we had some inclement weather enough to throw it off track by a couple days. One more back here. Yep, yep, yep. Watch. Careful with that knife.
Yeah, don't stab me, please.
I'm not going to stab you. How did a preview end? Oh, they were celebrating and Jay got stabbed.
Yeah.
Thusly. Megan, yep, always cut towards yourself, Lash. Always. This way. There we go. I did it.
There we are.
All right. Here we go. Ooh. Ooh, look at the box. The box that comes in. It's very nice. Good box. It's a good box.
It's a good box.
Good box. Good job, YouTube, with good boxes.
Just open the
I'm thing. Opening the thing! My finger was in the way. Stupid fingy. I thought it was going to be light. Oh, wait.
You want me to read it?
Read it a little. No. Yep, read the note.
Do you remember your first subscriber, your 100th, or your 1,000th subscriber? Chances are you do.
Yes.
And we actually do.
Yeah, we were actually
just talking about before we started. We're like, hey, remember when we were like, it was a fist fight to get to 5,000, and we were getting comments every day being like, you're the worst, we hate you. Your fans may have found you while searching YouTube, learned about you through a friend, or maybe showed up as a recommended video. No matter how they came to your channel, fans stayed and their numbers increased because of your unique voice and excitement of being part of your growing community that you established. We are thrilled to see the development in your community and proud to honor your impressive milestone of reaching 100,000 subscribers with the Silver Creator Award. Congratulations! We know that you have many stories to share with your community and that your fans can't wait to you and engage and amaze them even more with your commitment and creativity. So keep creating. We plan on it.
Yep.
Keep building. Yeah, we're working on it. We can't...
So it was like Susan knows what we're doing for the next couple weeks.
Susan!
She's watched.
We get it. We're working on it, Susan. Keep building. Okay. We can't wait to see what you'll do next, and we're here to support you along the way. And who knows? You reach your million subscriber. We may just write to ask, do you remember your 100,000 subscriber? Yours sincerely, Susan. Am I supposed to know how to say her last name?
Wojcicki.
Wojcicki?
Wojcicki.
Yeah. Great.
The current CEO of YouTube.
The current CEO of
YouTube. You know, this is a form letter. It's a very good form letter.
It's a very good form
letter.
They did
a very good job with this form letter.
They did a nice job. It's on good cardstock, but also it's like written in such a way that I feel like...
Ooh!
Yeah, it's good cardstock.
It has good cardstock.
There it is.
Here we go.
Well, they came with a card.
Okay, well, a little card. It's probably the people who made that actually made it.
Oh, this was inspected and packaged with great care by Rick. Thanks,
Rick. Thanks, Rick. We were here.
Hey, Rick.
Hey, Rick. We appreciate you.
Ooh.
Ooh. Ooh. Ooh.
And there it is.
That is nice. Why don't you hold it?
Huh.
That's cool. That's really cool.
Hey, we did it, buddy.
We really did do it, man.
Good job.
Can I be honest?
That's kind of fun, isn't it?
When we had this crazy idea, when we were doing the podcast all those years ago,
yeah.
And I was like, hey, I just found out that people were doing this on YouTube, like what we're doing, and like in 10-minute videos, and like, we should do that too. And then it turned into you and me just doing it, and like, hey, we should do this. This is fun. We're having a good time. And it was a slugfest getting to, you know, 1,000, 3,000.
Yeah.
Not knowing what we were doing.
And now it's our job.
Now it's our job. And we hit 100,000 subscribers. And and seeing all the other channels. I mean, because I've been watching YouTube for basically, like, YouTube is like my...
It's all I watch.
It's all I watch. Basically. Everything I watch is basically on YouTube.
I mean, and when we watch other things, we tape ourselves to put on
YouTube. Yes, everybody on YouTube. It's all coming back to YouTube. So I just see all those other channels, like, see them in the background, you know, because people are just like, oh, I just have my plaque just hanging in the background. Oh, I'm so awesome. I was like, oh, we're never, you know what? I don't know if we're ever going to be there, man. We've been working so hard. We've gotten so far, but it's like, it's still like so much. And then when things started taking off, and all of a sudden, it's like, man.
We made it, man.
We joined the club.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. This is so cool.
We couldn't have done it without
you.
I mean, literally and figuratively.
We really couldn't. So, just a heads up. This one's going in my office.
Mm-hmm.
We are
I
in the
got
process
a second
of...
One
we
are, for
yes,
me.
We're ordering one for Jay so he can have one.
He called dibs, and we respect dibs.
I did call dibs. I like how you can see yourself.
Yeah, it's really,
really
cool.
That's really nice.
Well, it's you too. The moral of the story is we've got a lot of really cool stuff coming in the works.
Yes, because Susan told us to build, so we are.
And we're glad you're along for the ride. It's gonna be kind of slow going content wise for us for the next couple of weeks
here on this on the reaction channel, a little slow.
Yeah, but check out our gaming channel. We're going to be uploading some Let's Plays and some really fun content there.
Mm-hmm. The link's down below.
We've got a lot of really cool stuff coming out soon. Mm-hmm. So just... And we'll keep you posted. Follow us on all the things. It's going to be a really fun spring and an even funner summer.
It is. We have lots of things coming soon.
Oh boy,
it's gonna be nice.
All right, we love you, Peaches.
Thank you so much for Peach. Thank you so much for this. Maybe in about 3 or so years, maybe we can get a gold one of these. Maybe
in 1 year. Maybe in 2 months.
Maybe in 2 months. Uh-huh. All right, 2 months. 900,000 more. Daddy, I want the gold one, Daddy. It's too early for that, right? No, is it?
My boy wants the gold one, and he's gonna get a gold one.
Daddy, I want the diamond one, Daddy.
Oh, boy.
How many? Is that 10 million?
I think it's 10 million.
Is it 10 million?
Which is, that's larger than some small country.
It is. That is. Daddy's.
Oh, boy. Well.
Thank you so much, everybody.
You're the best.
Batman reaction and review coming at the end of the week. So enjoy the Batman when it comes out in a couple days.
Yes. We're seeing Batman on Thursday.
We are seeing Batman on Thursday. We'll be streaming and stuff going on. The schedule's coming soon. We'll see you guys on Discord. I should do the thing, right? This is the thing?
Yeah, we got
okay,
it.
Okay, so do the thing. How would you guys rate all the trailers and our unboxing of this fantastically cool plaque? Let us know in the comments below, or hop in our Discord channel where lots of fun, cool people are talking about lots of fun, cool stuff. We'd love to have you join the conversation. The link is down below in our description box. And while you're down there, please like, subscribe, and hit that bell. Your turn.
It's the talking
plaque. It's the talking plaque. Yes.
We just hold this in every video now and pass it back and forth. Do that YouTube that you do so well. Guacamole's extra. You plaque-holding weirdos, you.
Other video is popping up, right?
Yeah.
Please watch this. We would appreciate it as much as we appreciate you watching this one. We'll see you guys next time.
Bye. Bye.